Our parents often help us with navigating our finances. You know, mom and dad kind of teach us what to do, but how do you help protect their finances when they get a little bit older? Alex Manassa joining us from Zarka Financial with more on that. Good morning to you.
Good morning. Nice to be here.
Good. Good to have you as well. We talk about, you know, our parents and some of the problems that may be going on, especially as they get into those older stages where the brain may not be working as quick as it used to, and they may not be as aware of things that are going on.
Exactly. You know, a lot of people are living longer. They're right. Let's say, becoming widowed as part of the life cycle, managing their money on their own. And a lot of times things can run into problems, especially with issues having to do with dementia.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they may not be aware. They may think they're doing the right thing, but it just may not be there. So you need to kind of step in and maybe help out with that.
Exactly. You know, a lot of people know the traditional issues about dementia, like forgetting, you know, if they forget who you are or forget where they live, that kind of thing. But it can actually be more subtle. It can create changes in your judgment, mm-hmm. Impulse control, in your mood, you know, things that are a lot more subtle, and it can really have an impact on their finances. So I'm seeing a lot of clients come into the office asking about mom and dad, you know, and what's going on with them.
We were talking about some of the scams that have been going on. We had a lot of the rain people, they had scams, some elderly people were being targeted just because, hey, we're going to cut down your trees, and then they ended up scamming them out of some money. But you see it with it more of a financial way.
Absolutely. You know, we see a lot of these, and there's a couple interesting ones I've seen lately. So again, seniors can be more prone to these scams. One of them was pretty interesting. The person got a bill for changing their real estate title, you know, for $200. And what's clever about it is they had recently recorded a change in their real estate title. So what's happening, can you imagine this? What's happening is that the scammers watch the wire, so to speak, okay. And see who changes real estate,
right.
Because that's on public record.
Yeah.
And then they send a bill for that, and the person thinks, well, I just did it, so it must be legit.
Wow. Even though is there a charge for it normally?
There might be a recording fee, but pay that at the time.
Right.
You know, you don't get a bill later. So
wow.
Another interesting one is they got a check saying you won the drawing you were in. And you know how a lot of people are in lots of different drawings.
Sure.
They enter everything they can. They didn't even remember entering this drawing ever because they never did. But this check, and the thing is, the check actually would have been good. The check was drawn on an unsuspecting company's account. So the company was a victim also.
Wow.
So what happens is the person cashes the check. The check is good. And then they're told, well, send in 40% for taxes to this firm. You know, so the person
right.
thinks, well, it's got to be good because I got the money. The check was good, but of course, it's not really their money.
Man, so how do we help our parents or some of the seniors kind of navigate that? Is there something that we can do to work with them?
Yes, these are some important things that I'm seeing people do. One of them is get a durable power of attorney. That's the document where your mom or dad names somebody, let's say one of the children, mm-hmm. to do everything financial and step into their shoes on their behalf. So this is like the badge of authority for the child. To be able to go everywhere and say, hey, what's mom or dad doing? What's going on with the accounts? But that's not even the only thing. Here's another big one. Get their passwords for online access.
Oh, yeah.
So that you can go on the computer and you can monitor what's going on, you know, with their bank accounts, with their investments. That's another really big one.
There's a level of trust that's there, too. You don't want to be maybe too invasive. You just kind of want to keep an eye on things. You know, you don't want them to feel like they're being hounded every minute, you know, but you do want to help them out.
Exactly. Well, that's why going online is good, because they don't necessarily have to know that.
True.
You know, of course, you have authority, you have permission,
yeah.
But then they don't really know. You're kind of watching, you know, but my mom or dad, they don't have to know exactly that you're doing that. So they can feel a bit more independent that way. Another important thing is to get permission from the advisors, the insurance people, the pension people, the bank people, and the financial people. Get permission in advance to talk about the accounts. I do this a lot with clients, where we kind of act as a team,
yeah.
You know, with the mom or dad and with the kids, and the kids can call in and see what's going on. And if I see something unusual, you know, I can alert the family if I see something strange or unusual happening, maybe nip something in the bud.
Some great steps to take. If you'd like more information, head over to our website, fox8.com, or if you want to call Zarka Financial directly, they're located at 29691 Lorraine Road in North Olmsted, right there behind Corso's. Alex, thanks so much.
You're welcome.
And happy Father's Day next week, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
All right. Much more.